from Biryani Ghar. Today we'll show you, me and Jamana will show you how to make Hyderabadi biryani in a clay pot. The mutton has to have bone so that it has the proper taste. So boneless biryani is not that flavorful as a biryani with bone. So we usually pick the bone off the shoulders or the legs so that it's tender. The other parts of the meat lamb are used in like soup or something like that, the tough meats. So we take half a kilo of meat, lamb meat, and then this we use fresh ginger garlic paste, so about 1 tablespoon. Then you have to make sure that with each ingredient you mix it individually, not like mix all the ingredients and mix it individually, so that you know the flavors are like spread evenly. So first ginger garlic paste, then mix it, and then taste of green chili. So this we can add according to taste, but you know, I would prefer it not that spicy. Then a bit of turmeric, just a little bit of turmeric, because turmeric has a very strong flavor, so you just need to make sure that you don't add a lot of it. The Hyderabadi garam masala, we make it in-house, and this has some different ingredients compared to other garam masalas in the country. So this is our trade secret, so I obviously cannot tell you what's there in this. So, and now we put the garam masala, and then again with each ingredient you mix it all over again. So as you can see, so the you should make sure that the meat parts are evenly coated, because sometimes what happens in the corners, there's more masala and then the other places have no masala at all. And then comes a bit of salt to taste, depends on how much you prefer. And the next one is this brishta, fried onions. So after all the masalas are mixed, then you add the fried onions. So this fried onions makes biryani a bit sweeter. So you decide more onions will give more gravy, less onions will give less of gravy. So, but also it makes it sweeter. So you should make sure you don't add a lot of it. And then because it is sweet, you have to make sure that the onions are also coated with the masala, so that you know the biryani doesn't end up becoming a bit sweet. Then you add a bit of desi ghee, just a bit, otherwise it will be very oily, so that you know the masalas are roasted in the ghee rather than in water. And so this, just a little bit, not a lot. That's the main difference. Almost every Hyderabadi dish has saffron in it. So that's what differentiates the Hyderabadi biryani from other biryanis. And then finally you add a bit of curd. And now that everything is mixed, we have to let it marinate for a couple of hours at least, or preferably overnight in a fridge. We don't use frozen meat here because in Biryani Ghar, because frozen meat becomes a bit tough after you defrost it, and it doesn't, the flavors don't seep as well into meat that has been frozen. And now this is how the mutton biryani is done. This is the marinade, and you leave it aside for some time. So now we see how to make a Sufiani biryani at Biryani Ghar. How we make it, we use fresh chicken meat that's not frozen, half a kilo of meat that's not frozen, and then we start with ginger garlic paste, about a tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, and then we mix the every ingredient that we add to the meat. You have to mix it individually so that the concentration of the flavors is evenly spread. And then comes red chili powder, that's according to taste. Then again mix the chili powder throughout the meat. Then a bit of turmeric, just a little bit. And then a little bit of salt to taste, depends on how you prefer it. And then comes the main ingredient, that is the biryani ghar special Hyderabadi garam masala. This is all freshly ground at our restaurant. We don't buy any packed products from outside. We make everything in-house. As you can see, we don't add any colors, any flavors to our food. Everything is natural and made in-house. And then as with every Hyderabadi cuisine, a bit of saffron. You can see the color of the saffron. Saffron not just imparts a color, it has a very distinct flavor and smell. And then finally, a bit of desi ghee. This we procure it from the local farmers in the surrounding villages. And then finally, some curd. It should be a bit sour. You should not use sweet curd for the marinade, because sweet curd doesn't... The acid in the curd helps the meat to cook. So it had the curd has to be a bit sour, not very sour, but just enough. So now the marinade for the chicken Sufiani biryani is ready, and we keep it aside for a couple of hours, or if you have time, we can leave it overnight in the fridge to marinate. So the marinade for the Sufiani biryani is ready now. So now the final ingredient is the brown onions. These are fried brown onions. And now with this, the marinade of chicken biryani is ready, and this we leave it for a couple of hours, or better still, overnight in the fridge. So while the rice is getting cooked, we are going to prepare the pot for the biryani. So you first thing is you make a layer of meat at the bottom of the pot. So you layer it such that they're evenly spread out. This is the layer of the meat, and then we add a bit of garam masala. This is a chopped coriander and mint leaves. Okay, now that was for the chicken. This is chicken Sufiani, and now this is mutton zafrani. So as you can see, this is both are equally spicy, by the way. Though this looks a bit redder because we use red chili powder, and we use green chili paste. So you spread it out evenly, and now you wait for the rice to get. So you spread it out evenly. Now we are making the rice for the biryani. So we have to make half cooked rice before we do the dum for the biryani. So this we soak the rice about half an hour before we cook. We use a double XL basmati rice. So basmati rice goes good with biryani because it's longer. The smaller rice doesn't really cook well. In fact, you can use smaller rice, but then you have to cook it for longer. This we first boil the water a little, then add some ghee, some cloves, elaichis, and darchini, and some shahjeera. And now we wait the water to heat a little, and then we add the rice. We add the ghee so that the rice doesn't stick to the rice grains don't stick to each other. And then after that, after the water is hot, then while putting it in the biryani, we remove the elaichi and the darchini parts. Yes, now the water has come to boil. You can see here, the oil helps the flavors of the garam masala, all the spices to come out. And so you mix it. You wait for the water to boil before you remove the spices out, so that the water is completely, the spice flavor of the spices are leaked into the water. And the final thing you add to it is a bit of salt. Now the water is boiling, and as you can see, you strain them out. You leave the shahjeera in the rice, and you strain the rest of them out. This is basmati rice pre-soaked in water for at least 30 minutes. We have to soak it in water so that it doesn't break when you add it to the boiling water. You should not stir the pot when the rice is cooking, because if you stir it, the rice will break into smaller pieces. So you will lose the grain of the rice, and it becomes sticky. So the ghee helps the rice grains not to stick together, and we should make sure that you don't cook the rice fully, because the rice gets cooked in the biryani. Okay, so now you can see the rice is getting cooked. You have to keep checking it. This biryani has multiple layers, as you know. So the first one was the layer of the marinade, that the meat, marinated meat, and then goes this layer of half cooked rice. And the same goes for chicken too. Same goes for chicken too. Now you can see this is the second layer. And now the third layer is still rice, but the rice which we remove last, so that gets cooked more. So because and now the use of the rice is the speciality of the biryani is all about imparting the flavor of the meat to the rice. So and biryani was like an army food, food of the army. When armies were marching, they didn't have any fresh vegetables and other stuff, so they used whatever ingredients they have and the livestock. So they used to kill the livestock, they could carry rice and the spices. So and they didn't have proper equipment to cook, so they just used the rice to seal the meat, to cook it and then seal the pot so that the rice gets the flavors of the meat. Garnish this with a bit of fried onions, and then comes the main ingredients. So the top layer, the biryani will have three flavors. One is the bottom, the top layer of the rice, that will be saffron flavored. As you can see, we use Irani saffron. So this is saffron mixed with hot water, so that you know it releases the flavors. And now we put in this chopped mint and coriander. At Biryani Ghar, we use the traditional way of cooking. So we are going to seal it with dough. When we were children, we used to eat this dough too after the biryani is cooked. So this is how we cook at Biryani Ghar. This is something that people used to cook a couple of centuries ago in earthen pots. And biryani wasn't fast food as it has become now. So in biryanis used to be cooked individually to each preference, like every person how he wants his biryani, that's how it's cooked. So this way it's possible to change the flavor of each biryani. If someone wants it spicy, someone wants it non-spicy. So at Biryani Ghar, we usually make our standard biryanis and just before dinner rush and keep it in stock. If someone wants a change of flavors, then it takes about 45 minutes to make biryani as to order. Most of our customers, they pre-call us. They call us before they come and then place their order, like they want biryani. Some customers prefer biryani that is without haldi. And we also have vegan biryani that doesn't use curd. So we have a lot of vegan customers that go for vegan biryani. But then all the customized biryanis are made to order. So you need to call at least an hour before and make an order for that. Let me recap in a short while how we make biryani at Biryani Ghar. At Biryani Ghar, we use all natural ingredients. We don't add any colors, any preservatives, any chemical flavors. As you can see, we use rice that is procured from farmers in Punjab. We use all raw spices here and grind our own spices. We don't add any color. And the most distinctive ingredient is this Persian saffron beef, which we procure from Iran. I can proudly say that we are the only place that not just serves in a clay pot, that also cooks authentic Hyderabadi biryani in a clay pot. And that too using technologies that were at least a century old. Even the recipes we use are at least a century old. The step is to seal this biryani so that the flavors that we work so hard at Biryani Ghar don't get out of the biryani. So what this sealing does is it keeps the flavor inside and also gives a pressure, so that this is called as dum cooking. Dum means pressure. So you know, you add pressure to the biryani so that it cooks faster. And at Biryani Ghar, we have been testing and experimenting with lot of ways to cook in a clay pot, on a flame, in a bit electricity and stuff. And finally, we have worked out after a lot of research, worked out a way to cook biryani in less than 15 minutes. The whole process takes about 20 minutes to cook, but the actual cooking on the stove is only 15 minutes. So another thing I want to say about biryani ghar is, since we cook biryanis in pots that are not reused, we also make vegetarian biryani the same way, so vegetarian people shouldn't be concerned that there's a mixing of vegetarian and non-vegetarian foods. So every pot is used only once at biryani ghar, and the veg pots are different and the non-veg pots are different. They are cooked separately in a completely separate way. So that way, even vegan biryani, we are the only place, I think, worldwide that serves vegan biryani. The only restaurant in the whole world that has vegan biryani on its menu. Now we cook biryani, most people assume biryani is a very complicated stuff, but we have found ways at biryani ghar to cook biryani very easily and in an authentic way. So we cook biryani on a regular domestic stove. Each is cooked individually on these range of stuffs. So now biryani on a regular stove, but the thing is you have to keep it at low volume, low flame. So the first 2 minutes it is at high flame, so that the steam we have worked out we tried about for almost 2 years with different ways of cooking, and then even we tried with different weights. So now the trick about cooking biryani in a clay pot is this weight. So now, as you can see, at biryani ghar we actually make it dum biryani. We don't use any aluminium foil or anything. It's just a clay pot and the marinade and the biryani rice inside and sealed with dough. And the difference now we make is this weight. We have experimented with different weights and now we have found that this is the best weight to cook biryani. And now with this weight actually seals in the flavors, it adds, it gives pressure to the meat so that it cooks faster. So now we put the weight onto the clay pot and wait for about 14 to 16 minutes. So now I don't know if you can hear if you can hear the sound of the steam escaping. Now you can hear it, the escaping of the steam is like a little bit watery. You can hear the sound of water bubbling. But that's from this noise, from this sound you can tell if the biryani is cooked. Because later on when the biryani is cooked, it sounds like frying, not boiling. So this is biryani ghar special mutton clay pot biryani. And this has been cooked in a clay pot. It takes about 15 to 20 minutes to cook. And now we see how it is. So since it has been sealed, our biryanis at biryani ghar are open. So now we are opening the clay pot. So you can see the texture of the rice and the saffron strands. And you know, this is how, and the now we mix the layers of the biryani. The first one is the saffron rice that we move aside, and then you can see the steam and the flavors coming out. I can actually smell it. And now this is the bottom layer of the rice, that is the masala rice, and then the last layer is the mutton. So these succulent mutton pieces that have been cooked in a clay pot. You add a bit of the saffron rice and a bit of the rice from the bottom. And bon appetit for Hyderabadi clay pot mutton biryani. So because at biryani ghar we cook in a clay pot with that actually makes the meat very tender. You can see how tender it is and how juicy it is. Because when you pressure cook the meat, it doesn't stay as juicy as it is. And cooking mutton is not an easy thing. Like, yummy. Second dish that you have to, must try this at biryani ghar. So you can see the saffron strands and the fried onions, and you know the way the rice is, because of the pressure it's standing on the end. So, and now since biryani is in layers, you have to take the first layer. You can see is the saffron flavored rice, then there's this rice flavored with mutton gravy, and the bottom layer is the mutton. As you can see, this the biryani, now we have opened the seal and the flavors all and the fragrance. I'm sure you can't see the fragrance in the video, but you can see the texture of the meat, the steam rising out of it as soon as you open the pot. So you have to mix it from the bottom so that the masala at the bottom comes and mixes with the rice. So now we are the right way to serve biryani is this way. We add biryani here, make it in a clay pot and make it individually. So you know, the biryani has to be mixed, the layers have to be properly mixed and then served. So as you can see, the chicken piece is very succulent and you know, very tender. And this is kachi biryani. This meat wasn't pre-cooked. It's raw meat that has been. You can see the grains of the rice that are perfectly cooked. They're not sticking to each other and they are not broken. This is then again mirchi ka salan and burani. You can call them the two wives of biryani or two girlfriends of biryani. Biryani never goes anywhere without them.